नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। ट्रेजरिंग टेक्स्ट 3 एंड टेक्स्ट 4 ऑफ चैप्टर 8 अटेनिंग द सुप्रीम ऑफ श्रीमद् भगवद गीता। टेक्स्ट 3, श्री भगवान उवाच, अक्षरम ब्रह्म परमम स्वभावो अध्यात्म मुच्यते भूत भावोद भव करो विसर्गः कर्मसं ज्ञितः। द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड सेड, द इंडिस्ट्रक्टिबल ट्रांसेंडेंटल लिविंग एंटिटी इज कॉल्ड ब्रह्म and his eternal nature is called adhyatma, the self. Action pertaining to the development of the material bodies of the living entities is called karma or fruitive activities. Brahma is indestructible and eternally existing, and its constitution is not changed at any time. But beyond Brahma there is Parabrahma. Brahma refers to the living entity and Parabrahma refers to the supreme personality of Godhead. The constitutional position of the living entity is different from the position he takes in the material world. In material consciousness, his nature is to try to be the lord of matter. But in spiritual consciousness, Krishna's consciousness, his position is to serve the Supreme. When the living entity is in material consciousness, he has to take on various bodies in the material world. That is called karma or varied creation by the force of material consciousness. In Vedic literature, the living entity is called Jivatma and Brahma, but he is never called Parabrahma. The living entity Jivatma takes different positions. Sometimes he merges into the dark material nature and identifies himself with matter, and sometimes he identifies himself with the superior spiritual nature. Therefore he is called the Supreme Lord's marginal energy. According to his identification with material or spiritual nature, he receives a material or spiritual body. In material nature, he may take a body from any of the 84 lakh species of life, but in spiritual nature, he has only one body. In material nature, he is manifested sometimes as a man, demigod, animal, beast, bird, etc. according to his karma. To attain material heavenly planets and enjoy their facilities, he sometimes performs sacrifices, yajna, but when his merit is exhausted, he returns to earth again in the form of a man. This process is called karma. The Chandogya Upanishad describes the Vedic sacrificial process. On the sacrificial altar, there are 5 kinds of offerings made into 5 kinds of fire. The 5 kinds of fire are conceived of as the heavenly planets, clouds, the earth, man and woman, and the 5 kinds of sacrificial offerings are faith, the enjoyer on the moon, rain, grains and semen. In the process of sacrifice, the living entity makes specific sacrifices to attain specific heavenly planets and consequently reaches them. When the merit of sacrifice is exhausted, the living entity descends to earth in the form of rain, then takes on the form of grains, and the grains are eaten by man and transformed into semen, which impregnates a woman. And thus, the living entity once again attains the human form to perform sacrifice and so repeat the same cycle. In this way, the living entity perpetually comes and goes on the material path. The Krishna's conscious person, however, avoids such sacrifices. He takes directly to Krishna's consciousness and thereby prepares himself to return to Godhead. Impersonalist commentators on Bhagavad Gita unreasonably assume that Brahma takes the form of Jiva in the material world, and to substantiate this, they prefer to chapter 15, verse 7 of the Gita. But in this verse, the Lord also speaks of the living entity as an eternal fragment of Himself. The fragment of God, the living entity, may fall down into the material world, but the Supreme Lord Achyuta never falls down. Therefore, this assumption that the Supreme Brahma assumes the form of Jiva is not acceptable. It is important to remember that in Vedic literature, Brahma, the living entity, is distinguished from Parabrahma, the Supreme Lord. Text 4. Adhibhutam Kshara Bhavah Purusha Shravadhi Daivatam Adhi Yajno Ahamevatra Dehe Deha Bhrutam Varo. O best of the embodied beings, the physical nature, which is constantly changing, is called Adhibhuta, the material manifestation. The universal form of the Lord, which includes all the demigods, like those of the sun and moon, is called Adhidaivata. And I, the Supreme Lord, represent it as the super soul in the heart of every embodied being, I am called Adhi Yajna, the Lord of Sacrifice. The physical nature is constantly changing. Material bodies generally pass through 6 stages. They are born, they grow, they remain for some duration, they produce some byproducts, they dwindle, and then they vanish. This physical nature is called Adhi Bhuta. It is created at a certain point and will be annihilated at a certain point. The conception of the universal form of the Supreme Lord, which includes all the demigods and their different planets, is called Adhi Daivata. And present in the body along with the individual soul is the super soul. A plenary representation of Lord Krishna. The super soul is called the Paramatma or Adhi Yajna and is situated in the heart. The word Eva is particularly important in the context of this verse, because by this word the Lord stresses that the Paramatma is not different from Him. The super soul, the supreme personality of Godhead, seated beside the individual soul, is the witness of the individual soul's activities and is the source of the soul's different types of consciousness. The super soul gives the individual soul an opportunity to act freely and witnesses his activities. The functions of all these different manifestations of the Supreme Lord automatically become clarified for the pure Krishna's conscious devotee engaged in transcendental service to the Lord. The gigantic universal form of the Lord called Adhi Daivata is contemplated by the neophyte who cannot approach the Supreme Lord in his manifestation as the super soul. The neophyte is advised to contemplate the universal form or Virata Purusha, whose legs are considered the lower planets, whose eyes are considered the sun and moon, and whose head is considered the upper planetary system. Thank you.